What's up, guys? Christian here with River Pools, and today I want to give you the 101 on pool bonding and tell you about the electrical shock that could occur if your pool is not properly bonded. This is 2 minutes in the pool.
Booyah!
All right, we're talking about pool bonding and the electrical shock that could occur if your pool is not properly bonded. But before we get going, if you find this video helpful, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook and Instagram for more educational pool content from us here at River Pools. All right, the 101 on pool bonding. Let's go. Let's set a 2 minute timer, see if we can get to the bottom of this before that little jingle sounds off. It beat me last time, and I'm not gonna let that happen today. I'm feeling determined. Hey Siri, set a 2 minute timer.
Okay, your timer is set for 2 minutes.
Let's go. Okay, the name of the game, the most important term you need to remember from today is the term equipotential. Now, equipotential is basically equalizing the potential of electrical flow around the entire grid or elements or all the elements of your pool. Think of it this way. If you have two buckets of water and a pipe between them, and there's more pressure in water on one side than the other, well, then that water is going to flow from an area of high pressure to low pressure. In terms of electricity, this is called voltage. It's the movement of electricity from high pressure to low pressure, okay? And so what we want to do is we want to equalize the electrical potential around all elements of your pool. We want to equalize all the electrical potential, equipotential. So how do we do that? Well, we need to get all of these elements connected so that the pressure, the potential, is equal throughout. So all of the metal components that are within 5 feet of the water's edge, including the ladders, handrails, diving board, jigs, all of those different things that have metal and are within 5 feet of the pool. We also want to connect the reinforcement that is used inside the first 3 feet of your concrete patio. That's called the bonding grid. And then we also want to connect at least 9 square inches of metal that are in contact with the pool water at all times. So how do we do this? Well, we use something that's called a bonding lug. And that's what this is right here. And we also use copper wire to run throughout the entire grid. We use the lugs to connect all of the components, and we use a copper wire to connect each component. So we run copper wire from the ladders to the diving board jigs to the bonding grid that's inside the concrete. How do we get to that 9 square inches of water? That 9 square inches of metal inside the water, in contact with the water rather. Well, we use something that's called a pool bond. Pretty simple terms. Dang it! Oh, so close. 2 minutes is up. Okay, inside the pool bond is this device. This sits, is incorporated into the plumbing of your pool, right next to the filter, and the water will flow through this. It's basically just a plumbing fixture. But on the inside is a metal plate. You can see that in the back perhaps. And then an element of zinc tied to it. Okay, so the water will flow through this 9 square inches of metal inside, so we meet that requirement. And a lot of times with pool saltwater systems, we've got to allow for corrosion. And so there is a zinc component in here that is designed to break down and corrode and be replaced over time, as opposed to all the other metal components of your system corroding first. And then we connect the pool bond to the bonding grid through this copper wire and that bonding lug. And this allows it to be tied in. Equipotential is now in place for all components of your pool, including the water. So let's talk about the fact that what happens if your pool is not properly bonded. You could get an electrical shock. But what kind of shock are we talking about? Well, it's really not that bad of an experience, actually. And more than likely, a child is going to pick up on it before an adult will. And it just feels like a slight tingling or buzzing or stinging sensation when you touch a ladder or hop in the water. It feels funny, it feels off. There's not gonna be a big bang of electricity or a big shock, that sort of thing, but just a slight tingling or buzzing. A simple call to your local pool contractor or your electrician, and he or she will be able to identify the problem quickly and create the solution and get things fixed for you so that your pool is properly bonded and you have equipotential between all components of your in-ground pool. I'm Christian with River Pools. I did not beat the timer today despite my determination. Unless you got your answer, we'll see you in the next episode of 2 Minutes in the Pool.